pyrotechnics and...
You name it.
You name it, they'll all be there.
And these are the citizens of Melbourne welcoming the world to Melbourne.
This was supposed to be a conservative city, but certainly the colourful clothes they've got on is meant to indicate something very different, something very creative and something very lively about the city.
First off, I'd like to offer you all a warm welcome from here in Melbourne where the sun shines seldom. You might be anywhere at all in this world, be boys and be girls, we're bringing gems and pearls, and like you, we're unique in the treasure we speak. In this music we make cultivates our beliefs, so let me kick an introduction on the drum and get beginnings begun and roll call the components. My name is Joe Listing, I'm Fleet MC, pesos on the scratch and your rock works to beat.
As far as I understand, the Graffiti Games is a reaction to the current policy that the city of Melbourne is trying to apply to street art. And it's kind of putting a counterpoint to the zero tolerance strategy of the city and encouraging artists to not accept the zero tolerance strategy, but go out there and keep on painting and do what we've done in the last couple of years, keep the city colorful and vibrant.
What you do, cause you love to do what you do, we do.
I'm glad that we can still be here in this lane and this artwork is here, because when I first heard about cleaning up graffiti, I thought to myself, well, yeah, that'd be like having the games in Italy and closing all the coffee shops, and closing the Colosseum and things like that, because it's part of the culture, it's cutting off a limb.
I moved to Melbourne about 3 years ago, and until then I never really did art or considered myself as an artist. And well, when I first moved here, I lived in Fitzroy and I was pretty much blown away by the art that I saw around me and started documenting it, and from there it wasn't a very much long way until I picked up the knife myself and gave it a go, and that's where it started for me. Yeah.
I grew up in the country, so you don't see any art outside of a magazine or a magazine basically, or you know, a nice pattern on a cow. So when I moved to Melbourne to go to uni, I just started, that's when stencil art started to take off.
This is my third year in Melbourne. I've came from Brisbane, South Australia to here for university. But also now, because I'm older, I see cities in a whole different perspective. And there's just so much culture around Melbourne. You can walk around, like especially with the streets, because I'm more interested in that. I can walk around the streets and see all these artworks and see how lively the city is.
In a gallery, you'll see a nice little card saying, this is, you know, untitled by Graham Smith. And on the street, well, for most stencils, you won't actually see a name. Graffiti, of course, is different. It's about getting your name up there. It's the name. Whereas stencil art is all about the imagery, and you know, you don't have to force any ideas or anything like that. You just and people can think what they want.
I guess I'm not really competing in the graffiti games, because the way the street art scene is organized, especially among stencilers, it's not really a competition. It's probably a competition in terms of pushing each other's quality, and but actually at the end of the day we're all working together and not competing against each other. There's a high respect for each other's artwork.
Doing graffiti is a competition that they're putting on themselves always, all the time. You know, they're climbing over fences, painting trains, and it gets painted, it gets buffed the next day, it's gone, and that's the competition.
I wouldn't say I'm competing, I'm participating and supporting the graffiti games by putting my images up on their website, or you know, by talking about it and this kind of stuff.
You put something up on the street, you got to expect that it can be buffed over, because it's an illegal activity. You've got to come to expect it. If you know, if you see someone the next day going over it, think, ah, oh, well, you know, oh well, there goes $10 worth of paint. No, it's no big deal.
This city is so full of artists. There's maybe a handful of anti-graffiti task force, and of what I heard is they're spending $1 million on it. That's fucking nothing. So I wouldn't be too worried about it, and that task force is going to disappear after the Empire Games as well. So let them play their game at the moment. They're nicely whitewashing, supplying new fresh canvas for us along some spots in the city, which is great. I thank them for that. And we'll be back after the games.
With the whole zero tolerance and clean up and painting over all the work, it's a shame that heaps of the pieces will get painted over because they've been around for years and some of them are just amazing, full of colour. And you'll see it one day and it's gone to the next, you're like, that's not cool, like, that used to be really nice. But then again, after the games, it's going to be a whole new empty canvas, a whole new place to restart and bring the city back up to what it was, or even better.
What you do cause you love to do what you do, we do.
I guess everything that surrounds me and matters in my life is my inspiration. I don't focus on a certain kind of topic, like, let's say, politics or social issues or pure beautification. I kind of touch everything that I am touched by.
When you do artwork and it's just going to be sitting in a drawer or your folio, no one's going to see it except for your lecturer and maybe the person sitting next to you. Whereas here you've got an opportunity to reach out to people you're not going to meet ever, most likely. The only people you're going to know that notice it, people that buff it off the wall, or you see taking photos of them and you walk past with a little grin on your face thinking, wow.
I can walk around the streets and see all these artworks and see how lively the city is. You can just walk around and you'll see something new every day.
There is a way of communicating without words because an image speaks so much. You don't need to know any language to understand an image. You know, that's the great thing about all these tourists here. There's probably right now more people speaking English more people speaking foreign languages than English right now. And that isn't a problem because when you have images, everyone can understand it.
We started off on street sides with hand drums. Upgraded to this, we're the grandsons of diggers and widows, immigrants, engineers, gamblers, jazz collectors and fishermen on piers. Our roots are panoramic, looser than pan jamming, from Sid to Melbs, New Plymouth to Pakistan. You could be on the bus, looking out the window, or walking the bush track. It don't matter what you're into. We've been chopping beats, talking about what we've been through. Now we've done the mic check, let the show continue.